A warm welcome to you to this webinar, and thank you very much for your patience. It's wonderful to have you with us, and what we endeavor here is basically to share some insights that we have collected across time, especially in the last few months as well, a lot of it in the last few months as well, on how the shipping and logistics industry is expected to transform itself in the near future. And also the role that emerging technologies is expected to play in driving this specific transformation. We found it very interesting. We found this subject extremely interesting. And as much as we know, adoption of new technology is no more a luxury, but a necessity in this climate. As we face a host of challenges, from ensuring business continuity, complying with data security security policies, need to optimize costs, need to automate processes, ensure there's enough liquidity and credit lines for operating the businesses, complying with global data integration and exchange standards, integrating with consolidators and marketplaces, expediting deliveries, etc., to name a few. So the name of the game at this point of time is disruption, and how you can actually disrupt your current processes and build better ones, build more agile ones, and claim the edge in the market. And as far as we see across every single industry, we see that technology is playing a huge role, especially the emerging technologies, which was not there a few years ago, is playing a very huge role in making this happen. And companies who adopt technology today are actually growing their businesses, the early birds are actually winning the race, if you look at it. The agenda for today is we're going to start with sharing some very interesting facts and statistics on shipping logistics. Possibly something that that you've really not realized or come across, and we look into after that we look into some of the challenges and the impact it has on the current supply chain management. We also are happy to present a case study of how the impact of a technology driven operations versus a manual driven operations, and once we see that, we'll also share with you on how we feel that technology will help you mitigate this particular impact, and also showcase a little bit on the new technologies and emerging technologies that they can adopt, with a lot of with a few proof of concepts, a few videos that of projects that we have done, and this will actually we hope that this will enlighten you a bit more, give you more insights on how technology can help you, and finally, we'll dwell a little bit on the latest trends on the logistics industry, and before we close with the Q&A, we'll also share a little bit about us in a minute before closing. Today, my name is Vinu Jacob, and I've got two subject matter experts with me on my panel, which is Arun Stephen and PD Sunil, and I'm also joined by my colleagues Naresh and Ram on the panel. So I hand over the session to Arun, and he'll be happy to take you on from here, and I'll join you a little later again on the session when it comes to the Q&A session.
Thank you, Vinu. Thank you all. Thanks for the patience you have shown, and you have taken your valuable time to attend this webinar. Now we'll just go through some interesting facts and statistics that we have collected recently. So we were just looking through what we can find and how we can make this interesting. And I hope this webinar is going to be interesting for you all, and we'll see that it is we do it properly. Now, logistic and shipping industry itself is a $1 trillion industry, and it's so big. So it is just a small part of a supply chain, and still it is a $1 trillion industry. It is estimated that around 8% of total workforce are employed in logistic industry. So when you take the world over workforce, 8% is working in logistic industry. And as a recent survey from KPMG says that by 2021, around 1.4 million jobs will be added to this. So we all should be happy because we are coming from the same industry. Now, Fortune 500 companies. Now, Fortune 500 companies, they prefer to use 3PL, that is third-party logistics, for their operations, extended operations. So they find that using third-party logistics has cost benefit, better customer experience. So if Fortune 500 companies are backing the logistic industry, you can see that it is a very revenue-rich sector. Amazon Prime, you must have all heard about Amazon Prime Air. What they intend to do is, already they have test runs, everything done. Any cargo you book on Amazon e-commerce site, they will be able to deliver it at your door in 30 minutes time. And how this is going to happen is by technology assistance. And they are going to use drones for this. They'll carry the cargo to your doorstep using drones. And during pandemic, you have seen that remote places in Africa to deliver the medicines and healthcare equipment, they were using drones for this. And this is going to be the new normal going forward. Now, we all think, okay, logistic industry is there now, things are difficult and all. But what the prediction is, the surveys show that in coming 2 years, there will be around 22 billion investment in technology upgrade investment in logistic industry. So it is going to be big, and we all should be ready for this. We all should be gear up to take this in. That is with some positive things. Let's see some challenges that shipping and logistics are facing. How many of you know that most challenging task of a e-commerce company is their cargo returns? And studies have shown that around 30% of all the purchases done online comes as return to the warehouse. Now, as I said, most of the Fortune 500 companies are using 3PLs. Now, this headache is pushed to the 3PL companies. And without a technology assistant, 3PL companies cannot handle this kind of volumes. They have to actually bill for the handling charges, correct? When the return comes, they have to bill for this. So without technology upgrades or technology assistance, these kind of things will not happen. Now, automated warehouse. We all think that automated warehouse are there. It is a new thing in the industry. But in 1969, in Japan, one of the warehouse was fully automated. You can just imagine 1969, it was fully automated. And it's the same year that man has landed on moon also. That is coincidence. But 51 years has passed, and you can see that only 3 to 4% of warehouses are fully automated here. And if you take the remaining warehouses or logistic industry, we can see that 70 to 80% of all the jobs done are on spreadsheets. Any of one or two processes will be still on spreadsheet or manual printed documents. So there is a huge upgrade that is waiting in the logistic industry. When you ask anyone in the logistic industry about most inefficient process, they'll all say that last mile, because last mile is very difficult to track. And this is where the most of the cost comes to a logistic company. And this is where many of the companies are investing their resources, their money, so that they can track the last mile and make it optimum. So maybe in coming trends like Uberization of the freight and all that will change the last mile delivery. You can track it properly. We all know that the cargo, most of the cargo are moved in containers and through sea ships and all. And it's estimated that in a year, around 790 million containers are shipped throughout the world. And out of that, 100 million is going almost empty. And this is a big loss for the logistic industry if empties are moving. So with new technologies like blockchain and freight marketplace, we'll see some changes in this also. Already there are sites like TradeLens. If you can go and see TradeLens and all, they already have implemented the blockchain, and it is going to be the new trend. Let's have some challenges that supply chain has, or impact or challenges that the supply chain has faced during this pandemic. So volatile demand. We all know the demand was very volatile. It was unpredictable during this time. And apparels, non-essentials like apparels were out of demand, and medical equipments, medicines, foodstuff was given priority. Some of the ports has reported around 30% increase in their cargo for these essentials, and reverse storage was full. Shortage of reverse storage was there, reported from CFS and ports. Now, this has contributed to accumulation of cargo in CFS, warehouses and all. And reports show that the storage charge incurred by the importers has increased, and some were discarding their cargo and just stopped trading. Now, this is a huge risk for the logistic industry. And without proper planning or without knowing these things earlier, we cannot address this. So here also technology or the data availability from the industry is very important here. During this time, we have seen port restrictions, slow custom process, hold up and rerouting of goods because of government prohibitions. And all this has contributed to the increase of freight charges. And you cannot predict as a shipper or a forwarder, once the shipment is already gone, you say that restrictions are there, you have to move to a different destination and route it through a different destination, and your cost increased drastically. And this has to be actually, we should have the knowledge to mitigate this risk. Resource utilization was another thing that has come in during this time. And you know, logistics was one of the essential services that was required during this pandemic. And 90% of all the workforce in logistics was reporting to the work, and they were doing the work. And the fast changing, unfamiliar situations, challenging situations has put high stress in this employee, and they were having difficulty. Now, the keeping the workforce mentally and physically safe has become a mandate now. So equipping with technology or giving assistance through technology was very important for companies, and enabling them was critical. Safety regulations, we all know now the new normal, you have to wear mask, you have to keep distance. Government is telling you to maintain all this in your warehouse or your facility, your office. Now, how do you monitor all this? So we'll show you some POCs we have done, how this can be maintained using a technology assistance or video analytics, how we can do that. In the first few weeks of this pandemic, around 1.7 million TEUs was pulled out in just few weeks from the shipping containers. So you can see around 45% of sailings were canceled by shipping lines. So it was huge. The impact was huge for logistics also. Now we have heard that what are the challenges, all that. With a technology, using technology, how can you reduce all these impacts? So from the technology side, we'll just guide you how things can be more mitigate the risk actually. So we'll go through one by one, and whatever we are saying here, we can assure we have experience in delivering this. We deliver these kind of services. We do consultancy service. We provide infra support for the customers. We have we outsource. If we cannot do, we outsource and get it done through us. So plan and reduce your cost. Now as a daily routine, you will be doing some process which is not optimized. So you should get an expert to analyze your current process and get guidance on the process improvements. empowering the remote force, enabling your back office staff to work remotely. And most of the companies have done in last 2 months, we have seen. We don't know when risk will come, when emergency will come. That time you will have to shift your complete workforce for business community continuity to another place. And this can be done only when technology is there for them to connect and work remotely. Digital tooling of the resources. Tech enabling your resource will improve the productivity, give them tools that can help them in day-to-day activities. Handheld scanners, portable printers, use of barcodes, QR codes, technology-driven task allocation so that you don't put more task on certain resources. You can divide the task among your resources. So that technology assistance is required for all this planning. Performance and progress visibility is very important for the resource. So you have to provide them with progress and performance visibility, particularly in a logistic industry, so that they are motivated to do more. So this is how the productivity will come from the resources. Now, engaging customer virtually. Now, you have seen maybe meetings and all we are doing, but that is not all. We can do additional things like auto-deliver the required reports to the email on daily basis to the customer so that he doesn't have to call you and ask for the reports. Then provide tools to visualize his cargo in the that is in the facility, logistic facility, or while it is in transit. That visibility, customers will their experience will be enhanced. Actually, online processing of the requests, booking everything, enabling chatbots to engage your customers, using BI or AI to provide predictive and prescriptive analysis to the customer. There are a lot of possibility to engage them virtually. Now, CapEx, prioritizing your CapEx. Now, this time you will think that, okay, who will invest in technology? How will find resources to invest in technology? Now, seeing what is the risk of not doing something is very important. If you don't do something at this time and you don't do a critical CapEx investment this time, then later on running through the years, it will be a big loss for you. And most of the customers are looking for their expectation. To meet their expectation, you have to be productive enough. You have to have the technologies to show them that, yeah, we are capable to cater to you. Otherwise, they will look for other vendors. Now, what I'll do is, we have some interesting POCs here. So I'll just hand it over to Sunil to continue with some of the POCs that we have done. So over to you, Sunil.
Thank you, Arun. The first thing is,
in the shipping industry, the documentation or the shipping process, the documentation plays a very important role. Now, suppose if you are moving a shipment from one place to another, an exporter, a freight forwarder, or an importer has to key in the same information in different systems. Now, for example, a shipment around 50 containers, which is a common for a consolidator, might have documentation running over 100 pages. And this information has to be entered in all the by an importer, exporter, or a freight forwarder to complete the process. Now, what we do is, with the help of technology, using OCR and robotics, we can take the information. That is, we can read the information, whether it is a PDF, printout, or whether it is any sort of document in any format. We can read this information and enter into a system. That is, it could be your system also. Similarly, where a user would take around 4 to 5 days to enter the system, with the help of technology, with OCR and robotics, we can enter the same in 5 to 10 minutes without any error. We can also apply the same technology for any repetitive or recurring task in any organization, just like reconciliation, documentation, reading of data, entering data, validation, etc., could be done in any technology, any process, any organization. Now, the next thing that we would like to show you is a visual. Basically, this is applied, if you can see, this is from a mobile camera where we are reading the car plate numbers and this is applied for a container yard or a terminal, wherein we can read the container numbers and validate and enter the same for a gate systems or entering or movement or location of the containers in a yard. The similar technology could be also applied for by the governments for raising tickets for a car or violations. Now the next thing that we would like to show you also is for a job of a tally clerk. In a tally clerk, this is a video that you see which is for a cement company, cement firm in India, where they are offloading cements from a truck. Now the same technology here, what we have used is we have used a mobile or your existing infrastructure camera or CCTV camera. We can capture with the AI and robotics, we can also verify what cargo is going in. It could be cement, it could be any cargo, metals, cartons, foodstuff, etc., where the system can read the barcode and enter automatically into a system. This technology is right now catching up in certain part of the world. Now the next thing that we would like to show you is a case study that we have carried out. We individually as a team, we have carried out in one few warehouses here. See, as you all know, the majority, as Arun also mentioned, the majority of the warehouses are still running manual or with a semi-automated system. The first leg of automation generally is enabling the warehouse with the software, which is seamlessly integrated with the real-time wireless barcode scanners that could carry out all your warehouse operation with the help of a barcode scanner in a warehouse. We have carried out this case study, which you see, wherein we have measured the manual process with an automation. On the left, you see all the warehouse operations like incoming stock, resource allocation, receiving, etc. This is a process which is applied in every warehouse. Now the parameters on the right, you see automation, equipment, human resources, errors, and etc. These are the parameters that we measured with. Now if you see automation is what we refer here is now majority of the warehouses are using, trading officers are using ERPs to control their inventory, correct? Now, what we do is we interface majority of the ERPs, mostly all the ERPs for the cargo. When a cargo comes in, you have an ASN, purchase order, GRN, sales, and DO, which we interface. So you can eliminate manual intervention and errors. Next is an equipment. What we mentioned about the equipment and software is we can enable the warehouse with the help of a wireless barcode scanners or mobile devices, boom receivers, or conveyor systems, which we will show you in the next coming slide, where automation can be enabled, where the process could be automated and accuracy can be maintained across. Dependency on human resources. Now, majority of the warehouses in which we have come across are having systems or not having systems or not having recording any information of received, put away, and etc., which is a manual process. Like, I mean, they would not have any record at all. So in that case, you will not have, that facility would not be able to apply FIFO, first in, first out, batch, expiry, serialized cargoes, and etc. So a control of inventory would be lost. No clue, or they would not have any clue of items placed within the warehouse. So the error possibilities, now what we have measured is the errors that could come without automation could be, you can have a wrong receive, you can have a wrong picking, you can have, therefore when you have packing and delivery could go wrong. The estimated time that could take for a process to complete with automation is over to 70 to 80% higher than the manual process. Now the next slide that we would like to inform us of the prominence of what we do in this industry, what we provide for this industry. We have shipping and terminal, in, uh, so, sorry, shipping and logistics. In shipping, we provide software for shipping lines. Shipping lines is who own vessels, containers, could be a RoRo, could be break bulk, could be liquid, any sort of liner business, we provide software. We provide for NVOCC, and majority of our customers are freight forwarders in the region. And we have software for shipping agency, which the prominence are coming down. We have software for ports and hubs. Now, what do you mean by port and hub is we provide software for husbandry services. When a vessel calls into a port, you have services to be provided for the vessel. So that the software tracks all the activities that to be carried on to the vessel, and it could be a one single network platform where a vessel owner could also participate. Now we have software for stevedoring, feeder operations, and etc. The next part is what we provide is for logistics. We have software for terminals, ICD, ICDV, and third-party logistics is one of our prominent software that we have, and CFS and distribution, container depot, and rail systems. Now on the right side, you see where we have customers who are using our software for over 20 years. Now what they have is from a manual system, they have automated to us, like they have taken a Vero software from us. And gradually what they have done is, as their business demands or the requirement has, they were using around 400 to 500 PDTs or the handheld scanners to do the process, which they eliminated by using an real-time distribution system, which is a combination of network from a conveyor system, the automated sorters and etc., which together will make an RDS. So from the manufacturer or from the shipment place, the information is transferred to a warehouse management system. The warehouse management system know what is the cargo that is coming in. With the help of a conveyor or a boom, we can receive the cargo. It can go through a conveyor. It can go and sit in any one of the five floors. Only the warehouse management system would know what is the cargo which is lying in each and every carton. It could be a mixed cargo and etc. With the help of an automated sorter, this could be distributed across the network or the sales order. So I will hand it over to further for Arun to carry out.
Yes, sorry, my mic was mute, sorry. Thank you, Sunil. Sorry for the inconvenience caused. So, from the online registration, what we have found is most of you attending this webinar are from logistic background. So, we have seen, Sunil has explained what kind of systems are used in the logistics. Maybe some of the systems that I am going to present here, maybe some will be aware and some for some it will be new. So like label printers, 2D scanners, everything we have seen, VNA, Ali forklifts are there. So all these are some of the technology already, equipments already used by the logistic industry. Now let's talk about real-time location service. Real-time location service we can fit equipments with beacons, actually active beacons, so we can track the forklift, containers, trucks, or any other asset you want to track. We can use the beacons, fitted beacons, and we can have a real-time location service. And this will be later on used in Uberization of freight. And Uberization of freight means where the location of the freight will be tracked through this technology only. Now VDM, VDW, that is voice directed warehousing. Now, how this will help us, it will guide you to each of the location where you want to pick. And the main benefit of VDW is your hands are free. So you can take the cargo, pick the cargo, pack it, all that. And the system will guide what is the next action to be taken. And mostly in European countries, the most of the logistic industry, they are very familiar with this and they are moving to this. We have augmented reality. This is something like our Google VR. So you are all aware of Google VR. What in logistic industry, what they do is they will just overlay the digital content information onto a physical world. So the complete warehouse layout is recorded in an application and this is stored in the system and your usual process like your picking, put away, everything will happen. So once you do this and you switch to AR, what you have to do is you have to just point to areas in the warehouse and it will tell you what items are available there. And this can be also used in the yard, big yards and all. You just point to a direction and it will say what all items are available there. It can build a route for you to just go and pick that using your forklift or any other equipment. Other is RF tagging and RF gates. We have seen some of the warehouses or logistic industry, they store high value items. So they use RF tagging and these are mostly used for security purposes. There are passive and active tags that you can fix to the items that you want. Passive is just like when it passes through a gate, it can just record that this item has passed through the gate or through the framework that we have created with the sensors. We can install sensors in all the places in the warehouse or the facility and it can it can just tell you where the item is lying, the exact position of where the item is lying. RPA automation, Sunil has covered few. We have covered in our webinar, that is in the videos that we have done earlier, where the repetitive process were automated using RPA and all that. So that is one thing that we have done. Use cases we have shown, just like a manifest uploading or any other repetitive task is there, you can automate that. So we'll just go to the next slide. Now, how many of you know, these are some of the driving trends in the industry. I don't know how many of you are familiar with these things. At least we have heard of these things and what it means. I'll just try to explain from whatever knowledge we gathered. Now, freight marketplace, soon you will see that you will be able to book your cargo on any airline, shipping or transport provider from your desk. All the rates will be published by all these providers, even though we don't see it now. Moving forward, they will be forced to publish their rate. And this is going to be the new thing that the freight sellers and the buyers will be on the same platform. So this is coming up. Freight marketplace will be the new normal going forward. Uberization of freight. Now, first thing that comes to our mind is the Uber taxis that we are used to. That shows where the exact position of your pickup car is there. In freight industry also, it is point A to point B, our shipments are going and connecting the, this is very important in the industry that provide visibility, flexibility for both shipper and the carrier. And the industry that is going to see the uberization will be the transport industry, that is for sure. And it's already in process and you will see that the exact location of your cargo, expected delivery time, everything on the real-time basis. Digital freight matching, if you see in our earlier slides, I have told you that there were so many empties moving around. This is because there was no digital matching done. There were so many cargoes where empty movements were there, but there was no cargoes to put inside that. So if an application or platform is there for digital freight matching, there will be a lot of things that will be reduced and you can have the cargo movement and more revenues generated, and blockchain and all will come into play here. Moving forward, data will be the core for many companies, and you know most of the companies, they have 20, 30 years data. They are sitting on treasure of data actually, through software usage and others, even Excel sheet, whatever, it's all data actually. And on the web also you have so many data. Using AI and BI, it's not that we will collect your data only or the tools will collect your data only. It is actually, it can collect data from other sources also wherever it is available. It can compile everything, then make into a prescriptive and predictive analysis for you. And AI will learn from all the actions that you have taken in some of the exceptional cases. So AI can learn. There is machine learning, there is IoT. Everything will be dependent on data and how data can be converted into action. Elastic logistics is very interesting. So moving forward, you can see companies like Amazon or Uber. Do they own any asset? No, they don't own anything, actually. They are just working on a platform that is built on a technology, and they are making money out of it. Now, moving forward, logistics also will be similar. Logistics will not invest on assets or like real estate, vehicles or people. They are not going to invest. They want something that is flexible to expand and shrink. So what technology companies will do is, technology companies will aggregate all these assets. They put in a platform where the companies can come and buy as required, just in time, you demand. This is logistics on demand. So that is how it is going to be. Hope these things are interesting. Now we'll go to some of the POCs that we have done. This is not directly related to shipping, but you can, from this, you can map it to the shipping industry. Now, you know, all the carriers, they publish rate, and we have seen a lot of companies entering their tariffs, everything. So we have done for an airline, what airline company, I'll just run this video.
Here you can see that it's fetching data from Make My Trip.
Yeah, so what we do is, using robotics, we are going to scrape the data from the web. So we are going to each and every site. We have a origin and a destination. So we are going to each and every site, taking the data in, putting into a readable format, and giving it, pushing it to a database or any other system. Now, if you take it from logistic industry, what we can do is, all the tariffs that is published by vessels, transporters, or any other, your overseas agents, that everything can be collected automatically using robotics. Now, this is a background process. We have made this video, but this is a background process that happens, and this is done by a bot, and you know, bot will not fall sick, bot will not ask for leaves. It is 365 days throughout, every single hour it is going to work for these many processes we can build into robotics. So this usually people take a lot of time to compile these kind of information, and it is done by bot in 2 to 3 minutes or 5 minutes. Now, I don't know whether any of the companies, logistic industry companies, are asking for customer reviews, but moving forward, when freight marketplace, Uberization of freight will be there, you are forced to ask for reviews. Now, what we have done is, we have done a POC for one of the hotels. What this POC does is, it just takes all the review from the websites, compile everything, and what is the task? So the manager or the person who is responsible to have the reviews, he has to find out the bad reviews very fast and reply to them saying that, okay, bad reviews are there. I have to say that, sorry for the inconvenience. So what we are doing is, we are going to Make My Trip, TripAdvisor, Hotel.com, all the sites, we are taking the reviews in, and we are just putting into a readable formats here. Yeah, readable formats. Just like here, you can see everything is compiled and put into a readable format. And using a sentimental AI, sentimental analyzer AI, we are going to, the AI itself will rate this particular comment that the customer has done. And whatever comes above zero is good, and whatever comes below zero is bad review. So you can see this is done by an AI tool. It is just reading through all the text. It is marking as bad. Now, the point number 10, point number 16 is bad. And immediately this is pushed to the relevant resource so that they can reply saying that, okay, these are bad reviews, I have to attend. So this is done by an AI tool. Now, if you have any questions coming in, you can just put in. Our colleagues are there. They can answer. If possible, we'll answer through the chat itself, or not, we'll just give you, we'll get back to you with the answers. Now, during this time, the new normal, we have seen resource behavior and gesture tracking. This is, I'll just show you the video. This is we have done for tracking whether people are wearing the mask. Now, you know, if people are not wearing mask, even here, you get fines actually. So inside the facility also, your resources has to wear mask all the time. So you can see this person is walking with mask. The using your current camera, we can identify whether mask is wear. When he removes, there is no mask. So all this is compiled and we can show you. I'll show you one slide where we compile everything and put it into a data format. So this is one POC we have done during this time itself, that is during this pandemic, what has come up. One other thing we have done during pandemic is something, this is not related to our industry, still you can just map it. Maybe the customs will scan the containers for items, what is inside. What we have done is the X-rays. So X-ray, you know, the load was very heavy on doctors. Every single X-ray has to be analyze whether that X-ray is proper, any infection is there. So you just upload the X-rays to this particular site, and what using an AI, it will identify whether this X-ray is normal or it has some infection is there, and it can give a positive results. So this is a small AI that we have done using artificial intelligence. It will be able to identify whether any picture it can analyze. Monitoring safety regulation. Now, you know, government mandate that you have this distance, you have to keep distance and move. So you can see that in this video, two people are there in the room, and when he goes near, the distance is calculated. So you have to maintain 1 meter or 2 meter distance. And what it does is when this is not only done for a room, we are done in a cubicle setup also. That video we didn't include here. But in a cubicle setup also, in an office environment, using your existing camera, we can measure the distance and produce reports for you. I'll just show you one report. Yeah, real-time update will be there. So these are all alerts will go real-time to the resources that has to handle this. So that when checking comes, you know that, okay, there is nothing wrong. We are all following the safety regulations. So I'll just go to the next tab just to show surveillance dashboard that we have created for one of the customers. So total incidents recorded. No social distancing, you can see 451 were identified. No mask wearing, 310 has been identified. Using thermal cameras, we can record the temperature also. Person entering the facility, we can record the temperature. We can put an alert immediately. And any intrusions into your facility, that also can be without any tags or without pushing the biometric, someone is entering with someone else, all that can be tracked. And this is something we have built as a dashboard. And these kind of things, we just want to showcase our capability. You can map the same to your business domain. So what we can provide. So what I'll do is we have a small poll coming up. After that poll, we'll go for, I'll hand over to Vinu to take us through the company profile. So I'm just activating the poll. There are only two questions you, if possible, you can answer, and it will be helpful for us to know what is your thought process. I'm just enabling the poll. Hope you are seeing the poll. If you can just, I'll give you 30 seconds to 1 minute for this poll. Just answer the two questions that we have put. Then we'll continue the webinar. Another 10 to 15 minutes is there. So let's give time for the poll. You can see the poll now. You can do the voting now. Then we'll end the polling and go ahead with the... Okay, we can see people answering to the poll. Thank you. Thank you for the participation. We'll just give one more minute. the main questions that we asked in this poll was whether your organization had any challenges in the business continuity during the pandemic. And around 74% of the attendees are saying, yeah, they have faced some kind of challenges in business continuity. So 75% is telling that. And some around 25% is, no, now it is 20% is saying, no, they didn't face any business continuity problems. Other question we asked is, which technology do you think that will be a game changer in the logistic industry? And most of them saying it is robotics and AI. And very few are there for freight marketplace, blockchain, and Uberization of freight. But as per our research, blockchain is going to be a game changer, because what they say in the industry is this is going to be like a internet when internet came. There were very few people believed in internet, and the blockchain is something that will change the logistic industry or any other industry. And it is very easy to implement in logistic industry because the tracking will be there. And we have a complete study material on this. I think most of them have already voted. I'm ending this poll and we are going ahead. I've given you the results. I'm going ahead. Yeah, some QAs has come in. So there is a request that can we attend the QA first. So let me just hand it over to Vinu for the QA.
Thank you, Arun. Thank you for you know, the lovely presentation, and it's my pleasure to you know, answer some of the queries that you put in, which I feel are very valid. One of the questions that was asked is, what is the return on investment in technology? In the automation space, you know, we purely work on ROI based projects, because automation can only work when the cost of automation is lower than the current operational cost for that particular process. So, you know, what we tend to do is identify those processes which are time, labor, and cost intensive, and address them first. And while we do that, the approach that we tend to take is that we identify the current cost and put in the cost of automation at a much lower level than what your current cost is, because anyway it's a no-brainer that people will only look at automation if it is going to be cost effective and it is going to give them cost optimization. The second question that came up on is, how does blockchain help supply chain process?
Yeah, I'll take that question, because supply chain industry, you can see that supply chain totally depends on paperwork. That is, you have manifest, you have the origin of the goods. Everything has to be tracked from origin to the destination. So the blockchain, how it comes is, it's going to record in ledgers what is the origin, what is the destination. All this paperwork from the source of export is actually published for the importer to view. Even the ports can access these published ledgers and see that what is the manifest, what is the coming up goods. So, and any change, see, if you are going to ship something from Jebel Ali to Mombasa and the destination changes and it goes to another port, there is a lot of paperwork involved in the current situation. There is a lot of things you have to do. Change request will go, amendment will go. Now, when a blockchain is there, the exporter will be informed that change of destination. Exporter changes his ledger from there, and it is throughout updated through the blockchain to the importer, the port of discharge, everything. So that is how supply chain is going to use the blockchain. And it is not, when you say blockchain, it is not the currency that you have to understand. It is cryptocurrency. Blockchain is ledger tracking from source to the destination.
When it comes to blockchain, let me also contribute to this question. Another very interesting use case that we came across was in the pharma industry. You know, we've done a solution which basically automates the entire the supply chain from a manufacturer all the way down to a patient or a consumer. Now, what happens is many a time there is a subsidy on medicines. So if there's a subsidy of one rupee or a one dirham, eventually what reaches the patient is only maybe 30 fils or 30 paise. So with this particular solution, we were able to make sure that, you know, almost 90-95% of the subsidy reaches the end consumer. So, you know, blockchain does really help, and blockchain is actually becoming a mandatory component, or very soon will become a mandatory component of any supply chain process. And governments are going to mandate it, suppliers are going to mandate it, and the entire supply chain will have to use it. Coming down to the next question, which is the accuracy of X-ray reading, that's a very good question as well. So in this particular project, we've used more of ML, machine learning. So in the POC that we did, we picked up a lot of X-rays from the public domain and taught the system to read the X-ray. Now, there could be situations where an X-ray is read wrongly. So that's where machine learning comes in. And the moment somebody says that this particular result, which is predicted, is wrong, and you tell the system that it is wrong, the system accepts that and then, you know, does not repeat the same mistake again. So that it learns from that, and the next time a similar X-ray comes in, it uses it. So, you know, that's where machine learning, we use machine learning extensively. Coming back to the last question, I think there is going to be an investment too, isn't it? So can you estimate the return investment through the savings you talked about, either 1 year or less? Many a time for small to mid-sized automation, the ROI is, the payback time is anything between 2 months to 5 months. And for larger automation, you know, we normally, it can possibly be anything between 6 months to 1 year, or maybe a little bit more. I think Arun will answer the next question.
Yeah, hello. Yeah, I think we have already explained how the 3PL and 4PL will use, mainly to find where the cargo origin is there. Now, you have sanctions and all in many of the, many countries have sanctions, and UN sanctions are there. And origin of the cargo is very important for any industry. And you know, from 3PL operation also, origin is very important for the ports. So tracking that, ports will mandate saying that even now, if you take UAE, the UAE itself is building their own blockchain technology here. And when government is building something, you will be forced to use. Now, when they implement, all the tiers in the logistic industry, whether it is tier 1, tier 2, tier 3, they will be forced to use the blockchain. And when the mandate comes from the government level, you are forced to use, and it will, throughout the supply chain, it will apply. So it is not that it is to 3PL or 4PL. Throughout the supply chain, this will be there. Now, I'll just hand over to Vinu to take us through the company profile, what we do. So over to you, Vinu.
Thank you, Arun. I think we are almost at the fag end of the webinar. We won't take too much of time. We were established in 1995, headquartered in the UAE. And we are present across UAE, India, Oman, South Africa, Egypt, Kenya, and very soon in Saudi Arabia as well. We focus predominantly, we do solutions for the logistics, shipping, and transportation sector. And that's what we focus on. That's where our domain expertise is. We've got about 350 plus people working with us, about 2,000 plus clients across 69 countries. We've actually been very focused on what we do, and that's exactly what we will continue doing. The reason why we stepped into the emerging technologies in the past few years
was predominantly to support our existing customers in upgrading their technology platforms so that they have the edge when it comes to operations. So we invested a lot in building skill sets for RPA, the robotics process robotics and process automation utilities. We did a lot of work around analytics, right from data analytics to voice analytics to video analytics, which you saw, and now even from predictive to prescriptive analytics. So we basically use analytics, do a prediction, and even then take the next action in terms of what needs to be done, and we even complete the action so that that completes the cycle. We do a lot of very specialized work on e-commerce side as well. Apart from just normal e-commerce systems, we specialize in bringing specialized content in. We specialize in bringing in specialized payment platforms, increasing adoptions, enabling automated market intelligence, and all of that as a part of our e-commerce solutions. Payment solutions and fintech is another area that we focus on. In terms of building virtual card adapters, enabling virtual VCA platforms, corporate card and large card platforms, helping customers increase their credit lines and credit usage, and building a lot of integrations. We are partners with Oracle, Microsoft, and SAP. Amazon and all of that. So we've actually built our strategic alliances across time, and these are very long-standing strategic alliances. We've also recently stepped into the expense management area with SAP Concur, and we represent them as well. Before I close, just a quick just to quickly show you some of our clients. We work with companies like Emirates Airlines. We built an automated distribution platform, automotive distribution platforms for Nissan. We work with companies like IKEA and Adidas and Skechers and apparel for automating a lot of their logistics operations, and a lot of other government and large enterprise customers as well. So with that, I think we've just come to the end of our presentation, and we hope that you've enjoyed it. We really thank you so much for your participation, for making it interactive, and also sharing your insights with us, which we have also learned as we gone on. So if you have no more questions, we'd like to take this opportunity to thank you very much for joining us. And we'll keep you informed about the future webinars that we're coming up with on specific specialized subjects. We look forward to being of service to you at any time that you think, because we are a team led by passion, and consulting on these domains is a passion for us more than anything else. So we'll be happy to share insights with you, and we'd like to encourage you to reach out to us anytime. And thank you once again very much for joining us. Thank you very much. Thank you, team.
Yeah, some people are asking for recordings, so you can just email IDs are there with the invite, so you can just write to us. We'll just share the recordings for you. Even we can have one-to-one sessions if required. We can go in detail how we can help you out. So thank you very much. We are ending this. Thank you.